Hey, Paul here, and wanted to just walk you through some of the steps that are involved in completing a Louisiana succession. And it's a tough one to explain because every succession or probate is different. You know, everyone has different participants or heirs involved. Everyone has different types of assets or debts involved. Each succession has different will or trust provisions that have to be looked at. So everyone is different. And so you've got to develop a plan from the beginning based upon the circumstances that are involved and then make sure everybody's on board to get things done. So I want to walk you through one where dad passed away and he had three children. He had a will. He named one of the children as the executor. And the kind of assets that the dad owned were, and he just passed away a few days ago, but the kind of assets that he had were he had some brokerage accounts that are now frozen. He had some IRAs, both traditional and Roth IRAs. He has some bank accounts that are now frozen. He has some United States savings bonds that are in his name. He's due a refund check to his estate from the facility that he was living in. And he's due a refund check that will be payable to his estate from the IRS. So what do you do with all that stuff? So as I walked through it with the family this morning, you know, we talked about the five or six steps that were going to be necessary. The first step was to get the executor confirmed as the executor. Takes several weeks to do that. We'll be filing all the court paperwork with the original will, and a judge ultimately will sign an order confirming that the will is valid and the son is confirmed as the executor. And then the clerk of court will issue these what's called letters of independent executorship, which the son can take to different financial institutions and the son can show to different third parties that show that he has the authority to transact on behalf of his father's estate. He'll then go open up an estate account. Once he's confirmed by the court as the executor, he'll open up an estate account and he'll sell those something like 7 or 8 dozen United States savings bonds. And the money will go into the estate account as he gets these refund checks from the IRS and the facility where his father lived. He'll deposit those in the estate account because if checks are payable to the estate of someone, you can't deposit those into their ordinary bank account. So in addition, the family will start working with the financial institutions where he had traditional and Roth IRAs. New inherited IRAs will be set up on behalf of the children. And then we'll prepare all the necessary accountings and court documents showing the assets and how things are being managed. And then at the end of the day, this might be 6 months from now, it might be a year from now, because things just at the courthouse don't happen that quickly. Then a judge will sign a final court order ordering that the brokerage account assets and other assets be transferred from the estate to the three children equally. So in this matter, the children already had brokerage accounts. Once we get those court orders, it should be pretty simple to move those assets from the parents' estate in, you know, equally in three parts to the three different children's accounts. So more to it than that, but just wanted to give you that quick overview. I know in this circumstance, stuff will come up. It always does while we're working on these things. Like I told the family, we'll just deal with it when it comes up. So if you've had a family member pass away, there's assets there, the family's cooperative, which is really the only way to get these things done. If one participant is uncooperative, it seems like things never, you know, finish up without years of chaos and litigation and difficulty. So really important for all of those participants to get along and agree on that appropriate plan of action. So if you'd like some help with that, give our office a call. Our toll-free number anywhere in the state, 866-491-3884. So y'all have a good day.